The director in charge of tourism and business development at Uganda Wildlife Authority, Stephen Masaba, was handed over to police by the Kosasi chairperson, Medard Segwana, to record statements after discovering mess in the contract.
A member of the contracts committee during the procurement of MFI said that I was a member of CC contracts committee, and I wanted to confirm whether I had left before MFI came in and not. So I said I would want to check whether the period when I was a CC member.
That's not what you said.
Okay.
Were you or were you not?
Yes.
Kosasi established that Uganda Wildlife Authority contracted MFI, an Indian firm, to develop and install a reservation, booking, payment and park access system at a contract sum of 300 million shillings without carrying out due diligence on the company.
We are lay people. We are not lawyers. How do you conduct a procurement without due diligence?
We didn't do due diligence. And based on the failure on performance of MFI, we had to go careful before we engaged another provider after advert.
What ACT committee members was that the company failed to deliver the contract after receiving a payment of 150 million shillings and Uganda Wildlife Authority ended up in legal battles.
It was contracted to provide the system, but the way how the company was procured is the question we're asking.
Members of Parliament established that this company had never executed a similar contract in Uganda, wondering why Uganda Wildlife Authority officials contracted an incompetent firm for such a contract. The committee also handed over Mark Opo to CID police, attached to Parliament, to go and retrieve minutes of the contracts committee that took a decision to hire MFI.
I ask CID, Mukoapi, and you enjoy the company of Mr. Opo, go with him to UIA, UA office, retrieve those minutes and report.
Kosasi has also queried Uganda Wildlife Authority on the working trend at which the lion population is shrinking in national parks. Members of Parliament accuse officials in Uganda Wildlife Authority for selling lions, especially cubs, to neighboring countries.
So reading, say the number is getting depleted. Is it the result of this? This part of it could be either cubs or confiscated. Because those are the ones you can steal.
Also, game parks and reserves. But it's very hard actually to see the young ones. I wanted maybe to know from them whether they're undergoing family planning.
Your people collude, get these cubs and save them.
The committee chairperson, Medard Segwana, warned that Uganda Wildlife Authority's inaction on the decreasing lion population is a danger to Uganda's tourism industry since lions pull a number of tourists.
Lions are the biggest, one of the biggest contributors of tourism. Now, when we do not see them reproducing, somebody would say that maybe those close to the border cross over, but the cubs cannot cross without their parents, when their parents are here. All the times I have visited national parks, I have not seen cubs. But yet you see males and females.
In the 2024-2025 national budget, Uganda Wildlife Authority asked for 10 billion shillings to breed more lions, citing a sharp decrease in lion population. It is said that Uganda lost 150 lions in 2023 alone. Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.